Hi there viewers, Steel Fabric here. In the last couple of days there's been a few videos pop up on YouTube showing some really bad cases of red light running. But it made me remember a story from many years ago that relates to red light running that affected my family. How it starts? Well, the story happens when I was about 14 or 15 years old. And me and two other mates decided to go for a walk through one of the national parks, which is south of Sydney. And it's a fairly long walk, several hours to do the whole thing. But we planned it out, you know, we prepared ourselves and off we went. We took ourselves off to this walking trail. And on the day, the weather wasn't very kind to us. It was drizzly the whole time and just overcast and drizzly. So we're walking along, and about an hour and a half or so into the walk, the track we were on met up with a big water pipe that came from one of the local dams. And this pipe was massive. You know, the diameter of the pipe was bigger than us. It was huge. And on top of that, the pipe was above the ground. So it had these cement support structures every so often that raised it up a couple of feet off the ground. So when we met this pipe, the other two wanted to jump on top of the pipe and walk along the top of the pipe. Now I said, no, it's too risky. You know, it's been raining, it's too slippery. We shouldn't be doing that. But they didn't care. So they jumped up, they clambered up one of these support structures, got on top of the bike, on pipe. I just saw a bike on the side of the road. They jumped on top of this pipe, and we just started to proceed along our way. And of course the inevitable happened. It was rainy, this pipe was slippery, one of the guys lost his footing, slipped off the pipe, hit the ground and broke his leg. So we managed to make him as comfortable as we could. We got him out of the rain by getting him underneath the pipe. We covered him up, we kept him warm, all that sort of stuff. I stayed with him and the other friend hightailed it back out of the park in the way we'd come in to fetch some help. Now this is a pretty big deal. If you did this thing today, you'd probably have helicopters come along and winch you out, but we didn't have helicopters then. So a couple of hours later, a team of medicos turned up with all their gear and bits and pieces and a stretcher. And so they got this guy stabilized, they put a temporary splint on his leg and put him on a stretcher and walked him out. And this whole thing was picked up by some of the local radio stations, and they put out a bulletin to say something to the effect that, you know, a young boy has been seriously injured in this particular national park, and a team of rescuers is on the way to go and fetch him. Now at the time that this bulletin came out over the radio, my parents and an uncle and aunt were in a car. My father was driving, and they were in the car driving somewhere, and they heard this bulletin come over the radio. And the problem is, the fella that fell off and broke his leg has the same first name as me. And in the bulletin, they only referred to his first name. They didn't refer to his surname. So my father, on hearing this, that, you know, what he thought was his son has been seriously injured in a national park, you know, it kind of rattled him a bit, and it took his attention away from driving. And he then proceeded to go straight through a red light. Now, on this occasion, we were really lucky. There were no other cars around. There was no accidents. No one was injured or inconvenienced or anything. So it was a really, really lucky situation. But that's my red light running story, and how it could have really badly affected my family, you know, with my parents and an uncle and an aunt all in the same car. And it's all because of a news bulletin put over the radio, because one of my friends was stupid enough not to realise the risks in walking on top of a slippery water pipe, you know, that's quite a long way off the ground. So my little story there. Ride safe, everyone. Till next time. Bye.